Thank you so much. I'd like to express my views in English so that our guest will understand, and those who are listening will understand that how the conflict of Balochistan established and that is how the state responded, which led to a serious humanitarian crisis in Balochistan. Balochistan being located on a very strategic location has always been deprived of the basic facilities, and despite of being very rich in mineral resources, have always been deprived of the basic facilities of life, like economy. The people lack a clean drinking water. The health condition of Balochistan is worse as compared to other parts of Pakistan and the world. The child mortality rate is highest in Balochistan. Similarly, the maternal mortality rate in Balochistan is highest as compared to other part of Pakistan and world. People lack the basic facilities of education. There are more than 5,000 ghost schools which only exist in the official records of the government. All this situation and the deprivation shaped the foundation of the political uprising, and which the state responded in a very cruel and brutal way, which led to enforced disappearances and extrajudicial execution of thousands of people. Balochistan has never been the focus of media. It has always been deprived or ignored, and those who have tried to cover any story related to Balochistan was either killed or went disappeared. In last 20 years, more than 40 journalists were killed by the Pakistan military establishment for highlighting the issues related to Balochistan. In the same way, the social and civil rights activists were killed. One of the prominent examples is Ms. Sabine Mahmoud, who was shot dead on April 24, 2015. For organizing a panel discussion on the enforced disappearances of Baloch people. After making Balochistan a no-go area, the military establishment initiated a military operation, especially in the northern and northeastern region of Balochistan. And when Nawab Burhan Bukhti's negotiation failed, they started bombing Dera Bukhti in March 2005, as it is clearly shown in the picture. Nawab Burhan Bukhti survived the attack, but the bombardment and the indiscriminate bombardment in Dera Bukhti resulted into death of more than 70 people, mostly women and children. In Makran region, where the political movement has deep rooted, have the roots, the Pakistan military establishment started abducting political activists in thousands. And during the detention period, they were subjected to inhuman torture, and later on released in a very critical condition and mostly named in very fake cases. In 2009, when Musharraf regime ended in Balochistan and PPP formed its government in center in Balochistan and Sindh, the policy towards the Balochistan didn't change. Moreover, it deteriorated. A military operation has been intensified during this period, when in April 2009, three prominent leaders, Ghulam Muhammad Baloch, Lala Munir, and Sher Muhammad, was abducted from their lawyer's chamber in daylight, and after 4 days, their mutilated bodies were found dumb in a desolated area of District Cage. The treatment of military establishment towards the people of Balochistan, or those who are raising awareness for the rights of people, were same. Either it was a political leader, a human rights activist, an educationist, or an intellectual. The treatment of all those people who have differences or who are demanding the right for Baloch people were same. It resulted into enforced disappearances of thousands of people, where they were subjected to inhuman torture, and later their mutilated bodies were dumped in several desolated areas in Balochistan. Since 2000, more than 20,000 people were subjected to enforced disappearances. 7,000 people were killed by the military. 4,723 people were abducted in last 3 years only. More than 40 students were abducted in last 6 months only. And the same way, 371 people were forcibly disappeared and 158 people were killed in 2019. In all these years, the military didn't act alone. They have empowered and sponsored the religious extremists to do their job and to act on their direction, just like Lashkar-e-Jangvi, Baloch Musalladifa, these and local death squads. These death squads were comprised of local goons and the criminals, which were empowered and they were acting on behalf of Pakistan Army when needed. They don't only abduct people, but they were having free access to the most critical areas and the most sensitive area, like Gwadar. As we can see in the video, that Shamir Aziz, the head of Lashkar-e-Khorasan, is moved freely in the deep sea port of Gwadar, which is the most sensitive area in Balochistan. The irony is, Shafiq Mengal, the head of Baloch Musalladifa, contested election last general election. Shafiq Mengal is responsible for the death of more than 170 people who were and burying them in three mass graves, which was discovered in January 2014. On the first day of the digging of the mass grave, Naseer Ahmed was identified by an ID card placed in his pocket. He was abducted by a military frontier corps 3 months before his body was recovered. It was not the only mass grave in Balochistan. A few years back, in 2010, three political leader, Aga Abed Shah, Master Safir, and Master Sattar, was abducted from Panjgur, and after 8 months of disappearance, their bodies were found buried in a single grave. Last year, another mass grave was discovered in Parum area, where remains of four people were found buried. In 2015, China and Pakistan signed an agreement known as China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, a multi-billion project. But to pave way for the route of the China-Pakistan, which connect Gwadar port to Kashgar, instead of rehabilitating the people and the villages which are falling on the route, they have started to obliterating the settlements of the people, and they adopted the policy of using excessive force. Military forces burned down villages to pave way for the for the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor route, which connects Gwadar to Kashgar. Due to indiscriminate bombardment and the military operation, the prime victims became the children and the women. Among them, a large number of children died in those bombardments. And the result of these military operations, the people were forcefully evacuated in large numbers. Thousands of people were displaced internally, and they are leading a very miserable life in other parts of Balochistan. And in recent years, Pakistan has adopted a policy of collective punishment, targeting the women and children of those political activists who are not in their reach or have fled to other countries to save themselves. In December 2017, Nazgul, a pregnant woman, was abducted along with 16 other women and children. She was later handed over to the local death squad and subjected to domestic work forcefully. She was denied medical assistance, and after eight months, she died because of pregnancy-related complications. In July 2017, prior to the general elections of Imran Khan, Noor Malik and her two daughters, Samina and Hasina, and her teenage son was also abducted, who are still missing. In October 2017, forces raided a house in Karachi where eight students were abducted, including Nawaz Atta, the information secretary of Baloch Human Rights Organization. Ms. Farah has resisted the abduction, and so the military forces threw her from the third floor of the building, fracturing her backbone. This abduction and killing was not new for Farah. In April 21, 2015, just after her marriage, after a couple of days of her marriage, four grooms, including her husband, was abducted by a frontier corps. And on the second day, their bodies were handed over to a local administration and claimed that they were killed in fake in encounter. Sammi Bukti was another pregnant woman. She was abducted during a military operation, and in that military operation, the forces bombarded indiscriminately on the Gandiara village of Dera Bukti. In those bombardment, her husband and her son died. After 20 days of detention, she was thrown from the helicopter. State remedies has failed Baloch people and have been proved ineffective in all those years. The police always denied to file cases, and the second option for the families were to travel all the way to Quetta to file a court petition. The court either instruct the police to investigate the case or file an FIR, which never happened, or to hand the case to the Commission on Enforced Disappearances, which is led by a controversial figure, Justice Jawed Iqbal. The Commission has deliberately spread misinformation to distort the truth and show the enforced disappearances of people as low and insignificant. In November last year, the families of victims of enforced disappearances sat on a hunger strike, which, due to its pressure, the government, who have been denying their involvement in the abduction of people in Balochistan, released few people out of thousands in a very critical conditions, which is the self-evident that the security forces are involved in mass abduction of people. and it arises many more questions. That few hundred people were released, but there are still thousands of people who are still missing and whose whereabouts are unknown. Moreover, hundreds of people were found dumped or buried in mass graves, and thousands of people were killed in all these years. The military, Pakistan military establishment was not only involved in the mass abduction, but they are also involved in organ harvesting. Two Zaid and Master Abdurrahman was abducted from their home, and later their bodies were dumped in this position where their organs were missing. Sadly, the United Nations was silent in 70s when Pakistan military was slaughtering Bengalis, and it didn't play its due role. In the same way, it is silent in the conflict of Balochistan. It encourages the military to commit more and more crimes. It's not only limited in Balochistan, it has now expanded to other provinces of Pakistan like Sindh and Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. United Nations is obliged to form an impartial fact-finding commission to investigate into these war crimes. It should take steps for the identification of unrecognized bodies. In February this year, 131 people were found buried in a unknown in a graveyard near Quetta, who are only their identification is only the number on their gravestones. The United Nations should held the perpetrators accountable for war crimes and war and crimes against humanity, and ensure the safe release of all and four disappeared persons. To take steps for the rehabilitation of internally displaced persons, and should bound Pakistan for the instrument it has signed and ratified. Thank you.
Abdullah Abbas ke mara joining or ya